Looking to turn some old cards into new fetch lands? Check out channelfireball.com's online buy list. We've got ferociously competitive prices on cards new and old, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you'd prefer to pick up singles, boosters, or even a battle box, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order, and soon you'll be rolling in villainous wealth.
Welcome, everybody. Today, we are going to be playing a little bit of Standard. And the deck in question is probably one of the most popular decks on in Standard right now. And by probably, I mean most definitely. And we are going to be playing Jeskai Tempo. The other Tier 1 deck in the format is, of course, Abzan. All the different flavors of Abzan. But this is the deck that basically most of the members of Team Channel Fireball are very adamant about in terms of it being the best deck in the format, and if not, it's the deck that they prefer to play. The reason why you want to play Jeskai over something like an Abzan deck is there's a lot more play to this deck. This deck's got a lot more instants, cards like Dig Through Time, and it just feels like you're making a lot more decisions in this deck. Now, on a power level standpoint, I think they're both very, very strong, which is why they're the two most successful decks in Standard. But this deck's got islands in it, so I'm going to be, you know, inclined towards playing this deck. Now, this list is very—it's actually close to, you know, the stock Jeskai Tempo deck, Tempo list. It's got the Jets, Strikes, Seekers, Rabble Masters, Riders, Charms, Stokes, and the only cards that kind of stand out a little bit are, let's see, the three Dig Through Times, which is very common in obviously all the lists that you see Channel Fireball play, and I love this card, and I would always play at least two copies of Dig in my Jeskai Tempo decks. It just basically says two mana, deal 8 damage. Team Channel Fireball played Nullified, and I found that Nullify has gotten a little bit worse. I mean, it's really good because there's a ton of creatures, but I've just had way too many instances where my opponents play a Sorin on turn 4 instead of a Siege Rhino, and I'm keeping up the Nullify instead of playing like my Mantis Rider, for example. So I decided to cut the Nullifies, and instead I'm using a different take on trying to fight the Abzan deck and replacing the three Nullifies with two Hushwing Griffs, which are also pretty good against Abzan, because it does prevent the Siege Rhino's ability from triggering. And I mean, they still get a big 4/5 Trampler, but that 6-point life swing is huge. And by playing the Hushwing Griff, you a lot of times can actually outrace the Siege Rhino, because you can play it, you can Jeskai Charm the Siege Rhino on top, and basically tempo them out. There's also one copy of Disdainful Stroke. I know this card's not quite as good because there's mono red in the format, but I find that against pretty much every other deck, there are relevant threats. I don't want to play more than one in the main deck, but I'm trying out one copy, and I've liked it so far. And also, moving into the 5-drop of choice, we have Stormbreath Dragon. Now, there's a lot of different opinions as to what the best 5-drop to play for this deck is. Team Channel Fireball did play Prognostic Sphinx in their main deck, and while I do think its Sphinx is pretty strong, I kind of wanted to opt for the just kill them strategy, and Stormbreath Dragon does a much better job of doing that. And when Abzan is the deck to beat and one of this deck's more difficult matchups, Stormbreath Dragon matches up so well against them, because most lists play 3 to 4 Abzan Charms and usually only 3 copies of Hero's Downfall, so they only have 3 actual answers for Stormbreath Dragon. Whereas if you play Sarkhan and you attack them, they can use the Abzan Charm to remove it from the game. So I've really liked the Stormbreath Dragon. I've been fairly impressed with it. So I'm gonna play this guy here for now. If the metagame shifts where Abzan falls out of flavor a little bit, then I will choose to switch back to the Sarkhan. And it's also possible that Prognostic Sphinx is good. I mean, it's very minor. All those cards are very, very good. But right now I'm opting for the Stormbreath Dragon. I also obviously shifted around the mana base a little bit because you don't need the double blue on turn 2 for Nullify. Now moving into the sideboard, we have pretty much Raptor sideboard with a few changes. We have the 4 suspension fields for the big green decks. one copy of Banishing Light, which kind of acts as a fifth suspension field slash another answer for Planeswalkers. We go up to three Disdainful Strokes post board because I think it's probably the best counterspell against all the green decks. We have two negates, for the control matchups, and we have two Prognostic Sphinx, which is much better because post board the games tend to slow down a little bit. People board in answers for your creatures. So having a threat that's much more difficult to kill while also scrying and helping you draw more threats and burn spells every turn is really, really nice. And then we have the one Chandra, which is something you bring in against control decks. It's just a nice little value card that I'm trying out. I'm not entirely convinced that it's great, but, you know, Chandra's got to be okay, right? Reveal a burn spell, it's like an arena. It's kind of awkward when you reveal your counter spells, however. This is basically a concession to the mono red aggressive decks. We have two Magma Sprays and a Scouring Sands. It used to be three Magma Sprays. Once again, I want to try Scouring Sands and see how it is against them. I have a feeling that it's probably better than Magma Spray, but I want to play a nice little mix. There haven't been too many other matchups where I board in the Magma Sprays, so maybe a 2-1 split is not the worst. So, Magma Spray is obviously far more versatile because you can actually bring it in against the mirror. It does kill Rabble Master, kill Seeker. And if they're playing the version with Ash Cloud Phoenixes and Hushwing Griffs, Magma Spray is obviously awesome there. So this is a list. We are about to join a daily, so hopefully we can take it down.